this lecture, I want to talk about OJ recombination. In this recombination, three carriers are involved. As we saw in radiative recombination and indirect recombination, in those recombinations only two carriers are involved per recombination, but here three carriers are involved for this OJ recombination. And in this process, an electron and a hole recombine but instead of emitting energy, as photons or phonons, the energy is given to the third free electron in the conduction band. Then the third excited electron comes back to the minimum of the conduction band. By releasing energy as heat. So in this process, if we see this statement in Venn diagram, then we can make three Venn diagram. So first, electron from the conduction band goes to the valence band, where this electron will meet with a hole. Normally, in some other recombination, this energy is released by this electron in the shape of photons or phonons. But here, in OJ recombination, this energy is given back to the other electron in the conduction band. So this energy, let's say it's h mu, which is equal to this band gap, and we know that this is EC and this is AV in all these Venn diagrams. So this is EC and AV. So this energy is now given to this electron, and now this electron will get this energy and will go to the higher energy state in the conduction band. Let's say this electron is now here by getting energy. So now one electron, the first electron, is in the conduction band, and this electron has given its energy to this electron that goes to upper level in the conduction band. So from here we can go in this direction and then again here. So now this electron will again release energy and comes to the minimum of the conduction band by releasing that energy. So now this electron will come to the minimum of the conduction band by releasing this energy in the form of heat. So this is actually happening in Auger recombination, and generally an Auger recombination occurs for heavily doped material. Meaning is that this Auger recombination is not possible for materials with small amount of doping. This Auger recombination is only possible for heavily doped materials, and there are two types of Auger recombination that is, first one is direct band to band Auger recombination, and the second one is indirect Auger recombination. Second type of OJ recombination is assisted by some traps. So by using that traps, this indirect OJ recombination is possible. So first, let me talk about this direct band to band OJ recombination. This band to band OJ recombination is possible for direct band gap semiconductors. So first, let me make here two diagrams of direct band gap. Semiconductors. We know in this direction is E and here K. So this is conduction band and this is valence band. This is one. This is conduction band, this is also valence band. So let first explain about this first diagram A. Here, if an electron from position A goes to this position where it meets with hole, and if there is another electron near to this, the energy released by this electron, that is electron 1, goes to this second electron, and this second electron will go to higher energy state in the conduction band, which is, if this is second electron, this is position 2 prime. If this is first electron, I am marking it, labeling it as 1, and this hole is a prime, 1 prime. This is 1 and this is 1 prime. So let me write this whole process. The two electrons and one hole This is known as EEH process. Is shown in figure or diagram A. Here we can see here electron 1 in the conduction band makes a transition to an empty state, that is nothing but a hole. Empty state 1 prime in the valence band the energy of the electron hole pair is then transferred to nearby electron, which is labeled as 2, which rises high in the conduction band to the state which is labeled as 2 prime. The excited electron now loses its kinetic energy as lattice phonons which is nothing but heat and returns to thermal equilibrium. This is all about EEH OJ recombination. But this recombination can also be possible with 2 holes and 1 electron. So this electron from level 1 goes to this hole that is located at 1 prime, can transfer this energy to another hole at position 2 prime, and by giving this energy, this hole can move at position 2. So now from here this hole can move here. So this is EEH process and this is EHH process. Here two electrons and one hole is involved, and here one electron and two holes are involved. So let me write it here. That is for EHH process. The electron from state 1 goes to state 1 prime and imparts its energy to a hole at 2 prime, which transfers to state 2 deep in the valence band. And we can also think process in a different way. That is, in this process, which is simple to understand, where one electron that is going to meet to a hole in the valence band releases its energy, and this energy is transferred to the another nearby electron, and this electron will go to higher in the conduction band. Now here this electron is going to meet this hole at position 1 prime. Now we can think that this energy is given to this electron, and this electron now will go to higher in the energy state of valence band here. So actually this electron from here to go here, but now this hole is filled with this electron, so we can see a hole here. So actually this energy is given to this electron, and this electron will jump to this position higher in the valence band, but we can see this hole now is at position 2. So here we can see that two hole and one electron are involved. So this is EHH process and this is EEH process. It's very important to understand. This is happening in direct band to band OJ recombination. And it's worth to note that the OJ recombination, is a third order process if RN is the recombination rate for EEH process, then RN is, so here RN is equal to CN N square P. Let's say this is equation number one. Where CN is the OJ recombination coefficient. Similarly, for EHH process, RP can be written as CP P square N. Let's say this is equation number two. Where CP is also OJ recombination coefficient. So the total, rate of OJ recombination is given by RA, which is equal to CN, that is sum of this EHH and EEH process, CN N square P plus CP P square N. Let's say this is equation number three. I can write here that CP is the OJ coefficient, OJ recombination coefficient for EHH process. And we know that in thermal equilibrium, the rate of generation or here we are talking about recombination. So first we can write that the rate of recombination must be balanced by OJ generation rate, that is GA. So GA can be given as, so this must be equal to the RA. So here we are talking about at thermal equilibrium point. So we can write here G as CN, N naught square P naught plus CP P naught square N naught. And we know that N naught is equal to P naught, which is equal to Ni. So by putting that value, we can write this as Cn N naught plus Cp P naught Ni square. We can put Ni square here and Ni square here. As we know it that at thermal equilibrium or for intrinsic semiconductor, N naught is equal to P naught, which is equal to Ni. So we can easily put N square equal to Ni square and P square equal to Ni square. And we also know that the excess carrier recombination rate UA, which is equal to RA minus GA, and this relation, let me write this as equation number, I think fourth. Yes, fourth. And this is equation number fifth. And we calculated or calculated this U in last lecture. So let's say this is equation number 5. So here by putting the value of this RA and GA, we can write this UA as CN N square P minus Ni square N naught plus Cp P square N minus Ni square P naught. Here by putting the value of RA and GA and by rearranging all the terms of CN and Cp, we can write this value of UA, which is excess carrier recombination rate. Let's say this is equation number 6. And we know that what is N and P. under low level injection, the OJ lifetime tau A can be written by PE divided by this UA, and we also calculated this type of relation in radiate recombination. So by putting this value, equation number 6 can be written as, or we can get this lifetime by equation 6 as tau A, which is equal to Cn 2 ni square plus n naught square plus Cp into 2 ni square plus p naught square, which is raised to the power minus 1. So by equation number 6, we can get this OJ lifetime, which is nothing but this equation number 7. So from this equation, it is evident that tau A equal to Cn n naught square, and but we know that n naught is nothing but nd, which is number of donors, by Cn n naught square. For a strongly n-type semiconductor, and tau A 1 by Cp N A square for a strongly P-type semiconductor. Strongly P-type semiconductor means heavily doped P-type semiconductor. So the OJ lifetime for heavily doped N-type semiconductor is this, that is 1 by Cn into N square. And for heavily doped P-type semiconductor, this is equal to this, that is 1 by Cp into Na square. And in the case of high level injection, such that PE very very larger than N naught, and PE also greater than P naught. So we can write tau A, which is equal to Cn plus Cp into PE square. This is the OJ recombination lifetime for high level injection semiconductor. Experimentally, determined values of Cp and Cn vary over a wide range. There is a lot of variation in the value of Cp and Cv, but in germanium as well as in silicon, both Cp and Cv, Cp and Cn are lower than 3 into 10 raised to the power minus 31 centimeter 6 per second. Thus, band to band OJ recombination in these semiconductors becomes important only when the mobile carrier concentration is higher than about 10 raised to the power 18 centimeter cube. And please let me check this scale also. It is centimeter 6 or 3. So OJ recombination in these semiconductors becomes important only when the mobile carrier concentration is higher than about 10 raised to the power 18 centimeter cube or 10 raised to the power 18 per centimeter cube. This situation can occur either in a heavily doped semiconductor or with very high level injection. And you can see what is the difference between heavily doped semiconductor or a semiconductor with a very high level injection. Both CP and CN increases with temperature. Because of an increase in the OJ recombination OJ generation rate GA consequently the OJ lifetime decreases with temperature. So, in this lecture, we discuss about OJ recombination. And OJ recombination is possible for heavily doped semiconductors. And for OJ recombination, three carriers are involved. These three carriers may be 2 electrons and 1 hole, or 2 holes and 1 electron. So we also talk about the types of OJ recombinations. There are two types of OJ recombination. That is, first one is direct band to band OJ recombination, and the second one is indirect OJ recombination. So this indirect OJ recombination we will discuss in the next lecture.